The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Welcome to worship this Sunday. It's good to see you all here. And I was going to start by saying, ho, ho, no, because we took a left turn at the beginning of July and suddenly we're at Christmas. How does that happen? But I did put on a little blue just for the occasion. And I believe Donna has some announcements for us.
Well, St. Nick would be busy. We have 125 pairs of shoes there. Last year we had 99. So they are going to be delivered to four kids this week. But if you miss you haven't missed your opportunity yet. If you mark a donation today that says shoes, Isabel and I will go out shopping for more shoes and we will get to four kids this week. Coming up, August, starting at the end of July, there's going to be a basket out there because it's Christmas, but school is almost starting. And we collect school supplies for SeaTac Elementary students. So another opportunity to show your generosity. August 15th, what is something every one of us has?
Blood.
Good. It is Red Cross blood donation on August 15th. You can sign up online to reserve your spot. And they also do need volunteers to help register guests. We're going to call them guests or donors. The other is Change for Change. Each year, the ELCA has a God's Work Our Hands. This year, the women's group started the project Change for Change, which you see the piggy banks out there. A lot of us have that change sitting around that just sitting there. If you donate it, what we are going to do is buy meal carts for the different people homeless that you see, that you could hand out a $10 meal card to them so they could get a hot meal at a local restaurant. So far, we have received $255. So that will end September 8th. So your generosity is outstanding. Just wonderful to see. Thank you.
Thank you, Donna. Are there any other announcements at this time? If not, please rise for our confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever.
Amen.
God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit, that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another, kneeling as we are able. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed,
by what we have done,
and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. From the peace, for the peace from above, and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth.
Lord God, heaven, in almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory, for Jesus Christ, Holy Son of the Father, Lord God and Lord God, you take away the sin of the world.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you made this night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The first reading is from Amos. This is what the Lord God showed me. The Lord was standing beside a wall built with a plumb line, with a plumb line in his hand. And the Lord said to me, Amos, what do you see? And I said, a plumb line. Then the Lord said, I thought so. Sorry. The first reading is from Isaiah chapter 9. Oh, thank you. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks
be to God. Psalm 96 will be spoken responsively. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth.
Sing to the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord.
Declare God's glory among the nations and God's wonders among all peoples.
For great is the Lord, and great to be praised, more to be feared than all gods.
As for all the gods of the nations, they are but idols, but you, O Lord, have made the heavens.
Majesty and magnificence are in your presence. Power and splendor are in your sanctuary.
Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples, ascribe to the Lord honor and power.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor due to the Holy Name. Bring your offerings and intercourse to the Lord.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of his holiness. Tremble before the Lord, all the earth.
Gather out among the nations, the Lord is King, the one who made the world so firm that it cannot be moved, who judged the peoples with equity.
Let the heavens rejoice, and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder and all that is in it. Let the field be joyful and all that is therein.
Then shall all the trees of the wood shout for joy at the coming. O Lord, you will not judge your earth.
You will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with your truth. The second reading is from Titus chapter 2. The grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impiety and worldly passions, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, whilst we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. He it is who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify for himself a people of his own who are zealous for good deeds. The word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the second chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about the child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
So Jesus is born. Who knew? It's an interesting thing to ask, because throughout all of our lives, when we think of Christmas, we realize that many people throughout the world celebrate with us. But what we forget is how few people actually knew the night when he actually came into this world. Oh, sure, there were magi who anticipated him coming. They had paid attention to the stars. They knew that something was going to happen. But that night, other than the people who saw Mary was close to giving birth, other than the people who told them that they could use the manger in that area where the animals stayed, other than the shepherds and the angels, who else knew? It's important that we remember how few knew about Jesus. And the reason is because how many people know now about the Lord? And how do you imagine that happened? If Jesus had done nothing spectacular or amazing throughout his life, what would we know of Jesus? If those who met him hadn't spoken of them, how would we know those stories? What if the apostles that were sent out decided that what Jesus had asked of them was just too much? Jesus expects too much of me. I can't do it. How would we know? And the amazing thing is that we do know. And there are still people today that are hearing. And they're not hearing only from people who stand in places like this, wearing things like this, but they're hearing from you. And they're seeing Christ in your life. And more people are growing in their knowledge of Jesus Christ. This, you know, you've heard all of the wonderful things that are going on here in the congregation. How we're reaching out and touching lives. But the primary reason we are here, other than being the good news to other people, is also sharing the good news, telling them about Jesus, living the love of Christ in front of them. How amazing it would be if somebody looked at you and said, you know, I used to doubt whether there was really a God or not, but when I looked at you, I realized that there is a God. Because I see God in you. It's an interesting thing. We get wrapped up in Christmas and Easter and these days. And I remember years ago when COVID struck our world. And all of a sudden, for hearts that cared for others, churches closed their doors rather than risking people being infected. And the people struggled with that reality. And as a pastor, you heard those struggles. And Easter was coming. And the pastors got together on Zoom and said, whatever should we do? We were all figuring out, you know, there was no manual given to us that says, if COVID should strike, do this. We were basically doing something that one of my colleagues said, it's like we're trying to put a plane together while in flight. But the Lord brought us through that time. And since we weren't able to do it, the most important thing in my mind was that Easter was spent together. And I said, well, why don't we wait for this to blow over and then celebrate Easter? And my goodness, did people get bent out of shape. They wanted their Easter. They wanted it when it was supposed to be, not realizing that it does move every year. But I have a little magnet that was given to me as a gift on my refrigerator at home. And sometimes the smallest things in our life declare the largest portions of grace. And on that magnet it says, every day is Easter. Because Christ is risen. In the same way, people might ask, why are you celebrating Christmas in the middle of summer? Well, when is Christmas in your hearts? But every single day. We don't need to wait for a specific occasion to celebrate what God has done. We get to celebrate every single day. We all woke up this morning, hopefully in a good mood, took a deep breath into our lungs and said, thank you, Lord. Thank you for another day. And Lord, what would you have me do with this gift, this day that you have given? And look where you are, gathered among your friends, family, the family of God, gathered in this place and in similar places all throughout the world. We tend to echo the praise that was given this night. So I'm going to ask you, here comes congregation participation, I'm going to ask you to help proclaim the birth of Christ. If you look back at verse 14, let us join the chorus of the heavenly host all together. You ready? Everybody awake? Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those whom he favors. Amen. Oh, Alex. I understand you're about to go on a little trip. You think so? I know so.
Oh, wow.
Claimed by God, crafted with your own authentic gifts. And there are many. How about us work together? You are a brave servant, a disruptive disciple, called to be a participant in the 2024 ELCA Youth Gathering. In this, there will be times that you feel energized and times when you feel exhausted. Times when you will enjoy every activity plan and other times when you will wish that you were in charge. Times when the Holy Spirit will show up in joy. And times when the Holy Spirit will show up in challenge. And so I ask you, will you use your bravery for the sake of the gospel as you step into the journey ahead? If so, respond with, I will, and I ask God to help me.
I will, and I ask God to help me.
Will you use your authenticity to enrich the gathering in the community of New Orleans?
I will, and I ask God to help me.
Will you freely participate in the gathering and with people, the people of New Orleans, with the love and compassion of Jesus Christ?
I will, and I ask God to help me.
Will you seek to disrupt injustice, working together in solidarity for the sake of your neighbors?
I will, and I ask God to help me.
Will you be respectful, curious, helpful, open, and kind?
I will, and I ask God to help me.
And now I ask the congregation, will you, led by the Holy Spirit, pray for Alex, our youth gathering participant, in your daily prayers, asking for God's guidance, love, safety, and blessing in his endeavors? And upon his return, will you receive him and his stories, his experiences, with love and openness?
We will.
Alex, Almighty God, guide, bless, and keep you. Amen.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.
With the whole church, let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Joining our voices with the song of angels, let us pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. Kneel as you are able. The shepherds sing, Jesus Christ is born. Let your church throughout the world proclaim this good news. Over the hills and everywhere, unite the voices of all your faithful people in songs of praise and rejoicing. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Heaven and nature sing, joy to the world. Give respite to flocks, fields, and those who tend them. Come near to us in the beauty of nighttime, the shining of the stars, and the hush of the world at rest. May our wonder at your creation rouse our care for all the earth. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
The angels sing, peace on earth. Come quickly to still the strife of this world. Hush the noise of war and violence in places of unrest. Inspire leaders of nations to seek lasting peace and sustainable provision for all in their care. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Mary sings melodies of comfort to her newborn child. Bring rest and reassurance to those facing struggles this night. Shelter travelers and those without homes. Console those who lie awake due to pain or anxiety. Heal those who are sick or hurting, especially those on our prayer list, and those we name before you, silently in our hearts or out loud. Claudia. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
The heavenly chorus sings, glory to God in the highest. We give you thanks for all the saints who have proclaimed your glory in word and deed. Let us join them this night in joyful praise around your eternal throne. Hear us, O God.
God of mercy, come quickly to us with grace upon grace as we lift these and all our prayers to you. In the name of Jesus, amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Gracious God, you came to us as one unknown, bringing joy and salvation to the earth. Nourish us at your banquet table, that with all who welcome your birth, we may proclaim your peace, revealed in Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Mighty and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. And the night in which he was handed over, Our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ has set the table with more than enough for all. Come and eat at God's table. the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. Jesus, bread of life, we have received from you your table more than we could ever ask, as you have nourished us in this meal. Now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray.
Amen.
The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
Gift of Jesus.
Thanks be to God.